A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 10th February, Sunday. On the front page, you have this coverage on India-Sri Lanka relations at the Huddle, which is annually held by the Hindu group. So, this is former Sri Lankan President Mahinda Rajapakse, who is saying that how Delhi-Colombo ties means India-Sri Lanka ties have to be upheld irrespective of the government in power in Sri Lanka. So, presently we have seen how the India-Sri Lanka relations change when governments change. So, that is there. Then this is India rebuts China on Modi's visit to Arunachal. So, this is Prime Minister Narendra Modi. He recently visited Arunachal Pradesh and China objected to this visit. But now India has strongly reiterated its claim that Arunachal Pradesh is part of India. So, China claims it to be part of Tibet and therefore of its own country. Then this is, as new cases rise, leprosy in spotlight. So new cases of leprosy are being reported, but then government says that if there are detections of new diseases coming forth, if the numbers are rising, then it says this is a sign of better disease management. So earlier the diseases were not reported, but now they are. So it's better disease management, that's why numbers are rising. But this is a fact that leprosy cases are rising in the country. Then this is Twitter officials absent at House panel meeting. So the top Twitter officials did not come for the Parliamentary Committee on Information Technology meeting. They said that they were given a short notice, so they could not travel from US for the meeting. So we see that various IT related companies, they are meeting with the government and will have various aspects of social media issues which the government has that would be discussed and solutions will be coming forth. Regarding various sharing of information, regarding fake news and resulting in various crimes, instigating such malicious content, how should it be dealt with? And this is Mayawati do not distort oral observation of Supreme Court. So Supreme Court, we saw in yesterday's newspaper, has orally observed that Mayawati should herself pay for all the public money which has been spent on memorials. But she said that these memorials are in memory of ignored sons, gurus and great men born in deprived and oppressed Dalit and OBC class, and she says that these have become tourist attraction and a source of regular income for the government of Uttar Pradesh. And below you have Delhi CEO to counter misinformation campaign. So there are these voter deletion calls which have been made by Aam Aadmi Party, and the CEO of Delhi has decided to take action on this. That's for the coverage here too. So, AAP says that there is a list which Election Commission gave to it, which contains 24 lakh votes who have been deleted in 4 years. But then BJP says that this is a normal process. Voters are out of the list due to death, duplication, self-deletion, and there are many added also. New voters are added up too. So, it's a normal process. So, this is again a war of words which is taking place on this issue, voter deletion. On page 9 you have India set to overtake Pakistan in number of Hajj pilgrims. So this is Union Minister of Minority Affairs Mukhtar Abbas Naqvi, who said that India is likely to overtake Pakistan in terms of numbers, that is the number of Hajj pilgrims which are sent every year. So that is the entire detail provided here. Airfare and other details of costs are also provided. Then next is, then on Sundays, you have this who, what, why, when, where coverage. So, who is Rajiv Kumar, who is the Kolkata Police Commissioner, who was in news recently because of Center State crossfire. The CBI had been brought down to Kolkata to interrogate, and they raided the house of residence of the Kolkata Police Commissioner. So, that resulted in a controversy. Mamata Banerjee, West Bengal Chief Minister, went on dharna. Then what is the lowdown on Malia's extradition? So this also we have discussed over the week. So you can skip these news which we have already discussed over the week. It's not so important that you need further detail and further coverage. So Vijay Malia extradition also we have discussed how the case has been approved by Britain's Home Secretary to the extradition order of the court. But then he can still appeal to higher court. Then this is why are quakes happening at Palghar. So this is regarding earthquakes in Maharashtra's Palghar district. And when, this is regarding the recent rail incident which took place in Bihar. The Simachal Express derailed in Vaishali district in Bihar. And this is where in Northeast air links shrinking. So this is regarding the first civilian airport in Arunachal Pradesh. Also the foundation stone was laid recently. So how air links are providing are happening here. The demand actually has gone down. So the flights have been terminated. So the issues here are discussed. Then on Sundays you have the science and technology coverage, but these are Indian researches and development, so every week they do come up. So if there is something very significant you need to know, otherwise you can skip it. This is regarding the periodic table, then defines chemistry has turned 150. Then on Sundays the social, international and business news is covered in a separate section. So this in this section you can see on page 1 you have human elephant conflict kills 1,713 people, 373 pachyderms in 3 years. So pachyderms means elephants. So the human-animal conflict has resulted in number of fatalities. So that is detailed out here. And electrocution is said to be the leading cause of elephant deaths. Other factors include habitat disturbance, which are also causing rising conflict. Then this is regarding the Gujjar agitation. The Gujjars as such are of Rajasthan. They have continued disrupting the rail traffic for the second day on Saturday. So they are demanding reservation. They are demanding 5% reservation in government jobs and educational institutions. Then this is decoding Wangxia's ancient art of holding water in Mizoram's hill rocks. So there are holes in hill slopes where these were to channel water into rock fissures. So researchers have been studying these now. Rainwater trapped in holes to be stored in the fissures and veins of the rocks in Mizoram. Then on page 3, international news, you have Trump Kim to meet again in Hanoi in Vietnam on February 27-28. So it says US is ready to formally bring the Korean War to an end, which North Korea is even demanding. So this is a positive development here. Then on Sundays on international news you have the dispatches coverage. So here first news is regarding the Rohingyas who are living in refugee camps in Bangladesh. So they were mistreated, persecuted and were forced to flee. So this is United Nations High Commission on Refugees. So the ambassador, special envoy for it is Angelina Jolie. And this is deciphering the bellwether city of Britain. So this is regarding the city in Britain, Sunderland. So this for many years has been the place that won the race to first declare general election results. So in June 2016 referendum, the city gained new prominence as it became not only the first city to declare its backing for leaving the European Union, but also at a much greater margin than most expected. So again, this is not important for us, Sunderland. And then this is Afghan government left out of Taliban talks that we have been discussing over the week. Then this is an anchor for US troops in the Pacific. So this is regarding US-Japan relations too, military relations specifically. And this is the American capital's quest for statehood. So Washington DC is not a separate state and wants a statehood. So this is the issue discussed here. Then on business page you have SEBI and stock exchanges set up vigil. Step up vigil on stocks that are volatile. So new measures are being brought to minimize the probability of fraudulent activities. And this is pension scheme for workers in informal sector to kickstart from February 15. So this was the scheme announced in the budget, the interim budget. So this will start monthly assured pension would be provided. That is at rupees 3000, the minimum assured pension, monthly pension from 60 years of age. So this scheme would kickstart from February 15 only. Then on the last page you have scientists perform first in-body gene editing. So scientists have achieved the first gene editing inside the body. They have altered the DNA in adults to try to treat a disease. So if this is going to help or not, it is too soon to know. So many diseases are caused by faulty DNA and this is adult gene editing being done. So this is in USA. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website asia.com. In the current affairs section here, you can download the monthly compilation PDF too, which has been made available, and also the daily PDFs as such too. And there are detailed current affairs videos over the weekdays, so those can be availed through enrolling for this course. Details are provided. So that is it. Thank you.